Welcome back to our Proactive London studio, where I'm joined by Shishir Poddar. He is the CEO of Tirupati Graphite. And Shishir, it's good to see you. How are you today?
I'm absolutely fine, Tom. Thank you. And good to connect with you again.
Certainly is. We've got a bit of an update from you this morning. It is a trading and operations update for the 6 months from April to September. Perhaps you could start by giving us a bit of a summary.
Yes, Tom. So the first thing I would like to share with our investors and the markets in general is that there was a bit of difference in understanding of what we meant in an RNS in August with respect to what we expect in the period July to September 2023. So we said we expect to achieve a run rate of 50% in that quarter. And actually, it was perceived as if we were saying that we would achieve 50% of rated capacity for the quarter. That was not the case. What we actually meant to say was that during this quarter, we were seized to bring the operations up to 50%, within that quarter run rate, so that thereafter it is above 50 always. And from this quarter to 75. So by end of this quarter, we should reach a run rate of 75. That's what we meant. At times, words don't express everything perfectly. There was an error in the way I worded it in the RNS, but that's what we meant to say. Having said that, what I would like to share with our investors is, see, building a mine, bringing it into production, and ramping it up is a process. And trust me, you compare us with any other company in graphite, the time we have done to achieve the results we have achieved, you won't find a parallel. Please, we have been on the spot doing things, arranging everything in order in spite of so many constraints in a very different world altogether, with so many difficulties to achieve things. I can assure all investors of our company that your company is doing very well. It's growing fast, and we will continue to do that. Having said this, what are the critical things, Tom? With whatever we did over the last 6 months, the new plants that have set up, they've become completely, online, like a river flow. It's, working 24/7. So that's a critical thing, because when you set up a new facility like what we have, you do come up with hiccups, you do come up with bottlenecks, you do have to address them and ensure you address them successfully. We've done that. So, as time passes, now we continue to grow our production, grow our sales, and we progress. This is how progress happens. The other thing that I want to share is, we faced the last year a lot of difficulties in our infrastructure, and we took the challenge and rebuilt it. We've gone through the rainy season. Everything has worked well. And the third important thing that we achieved in this 6 months is that we aggressively went on to train our human resources. We are in a country where you're in the third world, right? So, and it's something that's an activity which is not something they've known in life. So training and bringing them up to the mark for operations is an important aspect, which in the last 6 months we've been able to do, the people are now very much accustomed to our operations. So I think it's been a very, very useful last 6 months for us. We've grown, as compared to last year, H1, we are like more than 2.5 times on our top lines, bottom lines, everything. So it's a great achievement in our assessment with all that we've done.
Plenty to digest there, Shishir, and we do appreciate your candor. And in the name of clarity, I did want to check actually, because in your RNS, the most recent one for this update, you do say that you are planning to raise some more money. Is that to help deal with the challenges that you've mentioned there, or is that to help improve the business in other ways?
We've already dealt with the challenges and successfully addressed them, Tom. Now we have to see that whatever limitation we have, how to address them, right? And the solution that we find is the most prudent. We have a challenge on the grade of the raw material that we use or the graphite that we mine, right? And it's saprolitic. So, you know, in saprolitic, you can say it's simple Mother Earth mud, right? And in mud, you may not be able to 100% segregate the interbands and the overburden that you find in a mine. So, you know, while you mine, there's a bit of contamination of the ore with the inter and overburden. So our head grades are lower than what we actually anticipated. So solution to that is very simple. You know, we came up with some brilliant ideas last year of splitting our pre-concentrate units, which are not very capital intensive units. They're small units at the mine head, which do the first processing. So we'll add pre-concentrate units and that gives us increasing, you know, capacity utilization overall for the projects. As far as funding of these is are concerned, Tom, so our intention is to fund it through debt. I think we have reached a stage as a company where we have a respectable, you know, revenue. We've proven a history of operating margins. No other graphite company has been able to demonstrate operating margins from even a 3,000-ton capacity to what we are now. So, you know, we are prepared. We are now demonstrated our performances and we'll go for debt funding. That's our idea.
All understood. I've just got one final question for you, Shishir. How confident are you that the 6 months to come will turn out to be smoother than the one that we've just reported on?
Well, Tom, 100% I can say, because, you know, this last 6 months has gone in with a lot of hard work, plugging every smallest hole in the operations that could lead to, you know, small breakdowns or interruptions in operations. All the holes are plugged. And we have, and it's 15, 16 days now. No, in fact, 18 days now since we've been running like totally smooth. So, you know, it's all addressed. So we are looking forward to definitely a better and far more progressed H2, and which means our financial year of April 23 to March 24 should be something that will change the company completely.
Let me wish you the very best of luck with it, Shishir. Thank you very much indeed for your time today. It's been a pleasure.
Thanks a lot, Tom. Always a pleasure to speak to you. And thanks for connecting us to our investors through these you know, video chats.
Very welcome.